Hello everyone, these are 10 upcoming RPGs that you should be aware of. But first, I'm Gaming Anon and I create gaming videos and reviews. If you enjoy this video, make sure to subscribe and like because it helps the channel grow. Gridfall is an RPG developed by Studio Spiders with the help from Focus Home Interactive. Gridfall is set on a universe inspired by the 77th century United States. The world is polluted, overpopulated, and plagued by a deadly incurable disease. The only hope that exists is a remote island that was hidden called Tirfradi that is untouched by the disease. So you will proceed to create your character, male or female, and explore the island in hope you find a cure and riches. The combat includes using pistols, swords, rifles, bombs, and also magic. You will be able to customize your character the way you want it, not only in combat, but in your decisions as well. Apparently, there's a huge emphasis on player choices and the result of them, and you will be able to approach situations in many different ways while you explore the island. Player choices are really important on an RPG, and from what we have seen so far, Gridfall looks really promising. Gridfall is releasing worldwide at September 10th, 2019 for PC, Xbox One, and PS4. Code Vein is a new dark action RPG developed by Studio Shift, which is known for developing the God Eater games. Code Vein is set in a post-apocalyptic world where a bunch of vampires called Vein have formed their own society and they are all fighting against the Lost, which are fiendish ghouls devoid of any humanity who wander aimlessly in search of blood. The player will be able to choose by a big variety of vampire abilities to unlock, but every time you do, your character will lose memories and risk becoming one of the Lost. The premise of the game looks really interesting and the gameplay also adds to it, with an action-based combat similar to that of Dark Souls, as you can dodge, parry, block and use combo attacks. Many cool Code Vein anime souls, but apart from the combat I can't see any other similarities to be honest, but from what we have seen so far it makes me excited to play it. Code Vein comes out on September 27th, 2019 for PS4, PC and Xbox One. The Search 2 is an action role-playing action game developed by Deck 13 Interactive. It's a sequel from the first Search, which was received relatively well, and it looks like the sequel is gonna improve in almost all areas. This time you can create your own avatar to play with, a feature that many people wanted when the original Search was released. The gameplay will have you dodging attacks while trying to find an opening to slash off limbs with the limb targeting system, so you can use them to craft new weapons and armor just like in the first game. The Search 2 will take place in a large city this time around instead of a factory, giving the player more freedom for exploration and experimentation. I definitely enjoyed the first Search and I thought it had some really nice ideas that needed to be refined a little bit more, and I'm happy to see this happening with the sequel. The Search 2 is coming out on September 24, 2019 for PC, Xbox One and PS4. Red Hook Studios' The Darkest Dungeon 2 is a sequel to the dark and brutal roguelike The Darkest Dungeon. Not many details are known about the game, but we do know some of the starting classes, which are Grave Robber, Leper, Mad-at-Arms, Plague Doctor, Highwayman, and Hylion. From the teaser we see a mountain area, so it's possible that the game will be centered around snowy areas. Redhook Studios proclaimed that they want to create a different structure for the sequel, but with almost the same combat system, but a little upgraded. I have played a lot of Darkest Dungeon and it's one of my favorite indie games, so I can't wait for the sequel. There's not a non-release date yet, but we do know it's gonna release as an early access game, so a 2020 release isn't impossible. Biomutant is an open-world RPG developed by Experiment 10. The game is set on a post-apocalyptic world with humanoid animals. You'll be able to create your character as you play the game, you will customize him with armor and cybernetic mutations. You will also have to fight countless enemies using the game's arcade action system, which utilizes a variety of firearms and melee weapons while exploring the vast open world. Exploring is also dynamic with using jet skis, balloons and flying saucers in order to get to your destinations. The game also includes a crafting system. Biomutant is set for release on December 2019 for PC, Xbox One and PS4. Dragon Ball Z Kakarot is the newest Dragon Ball game developed by CyberConnect 2 and published by Bandai Namco. It's going to be an action RPG focusing a lot on the story of Dragon Ball on the backstory of its characters. You will also be able to explore the world of Dragon Ball freely, flying around, and also complete the side quests along the way. I really like this idea of an open-ended Dragon Ball game, and the RPG aspects are more prominent this time around compared to Xenoverse. You will also be able to play with different characters as well. I have to say, Dragon Ball Z Kakarot looks really good from what we have seen so far. It's not on Fighter Z level, but it's second best regarding graphics in the Dragon Ball games. I'm a huge Dragon Ball fan and always picking up the games when they release. And I'm happy to see that Dragon Ball is still as popular as ever after all of those years. Dragon Ball Z Kakarot is set for release in 2020 for PC, Xbox One and PS4. Final Fantasy VII Remake is being developed by Square Enix. The original game is one of the most beloved Final Fantasies and also considered one of the best RPGs of all time because it shaped the way for future titles and essentially made RPGs popular even to the people that didn't really enjoy them in the past. So after all of those years, we're getting a remake, and so far it looks like it's gonna be a good one. The graphics are insanely updated using the Unreal Engine 4 engine, so everything looks up to par. The combat is now action-based, following Final Fantasy XV example, and many people are skeptical about this, because they wanted a 10-based combat system just like in the original game. But for me personally, I'm a fan of action combat more, and if they implement it in a nice way, the game will really succeed. So once again, you will dive back into the world and into the city of Midgar, and with the help of his friends, Cloud is gonna try to fight Shinra and save the planet once again. I can't wait to play this game again. I have been a little late to the party about Final Fantasy VII, but I loved it even now, so any remaster version is a dream come true. Final Fantasy VII Remake is set to release on March 3rd, 2020 for the PS4. Divinity Fallen Heroes is developed by Larian Studios and it's the sequel to the award-winning Divinity Original Sin 2. Fallen Heroes is a tactical RPG in the universe of Divinity Original Sin 2. This time, instead of an open world, you're gonna go through 60 handcrafted missions while forging alliances and making choices along the way. You will be able to level up your gear, recruit troops, and level up your heroes. The combat, as it looks like, is gonna be relatively the same, and that's a good thing because it's one of the best 10-based combat systems I have ever played. I'm really looking forward to this game because I really loved Original Sin 2, and it's one of the best RPGs I have ever played. I would even consider it my personal best RPG of all time. There's not a set release date yet, but Fallen Heroes is probably gonna come out on 2020 for the PC. The Outer Worlds is a new first-person RPG developed by Obsidian, which also developed Fallout New Vegas. The game is set on an alternate future that diverged in 1901, when US President William McKinley is not assassinated by Leon Cosclon at the Pan American Exposition. As a result, mega corporations are dominating society, terraforming alien planets and colonizing them. When a colony ship that your character is on board on goes astray while light traveling, your character is the only one that wakes from cryosleep. And then you will proceed to investigate the true nature of corporations while making choices that will define your own personal story in the world. About the combat, you can choose from a variety of weapons, futuristic and whatnot, and depending on where you place your skill points, which you get by leveling up, your combat experience may vary from person to person. I'm happy to see that Obsidian is back to the game and doing what they do best, creating amazing RPGs, and I really hope that Outer Worlds performs good so we can get even more games from them. Outer Worlds is set for release on October 25th, 2019 for PC, Xbox One and PS4. Cyberpunk 2077 is being developed by CD Projekt Red, which developed the award-winning Witcher 3, so expectations are quite high. Cyberpunk 2077 is set in a dystopian night city of California, and it's going to be an overworld first-person RPG that will have you playing as V, a mercenary who can customize to your liking while exploring the game's 6 distinct regions and making decisions that will impact your character and the world around you. The combat of the game allows you to use futuristic firearms, cybernetics, and melee. Stealth is also a valuable option. There is a big emphasis on the story of the game, and CD Projekt Red is really setting the bar high with the inclusion of high-class actors like Keanu Reeves. So I'm pretty excited for this game, and I'm sure CD Projekt Red will deliver. Cyberpunk 2077 is set for release on 16 April 2020 for PC, Xbox One and PS4. These were 10 upcoming RPGs that you should be aware of. If you like the video, don't forget to subscribe and like the video because it helps the channel grow. What's your most anticipated RPG? Type in the comments down below. Thanks for watching. Have a fantastic day.